What are stable swap pools and what are they good for? Well, first of all, you need to know what's a liquidity pool and how it uses mostly the automated market maker model to keep its assets in a reasonable balance. We've covered it in our video about impermanent loss. To put it briefly, when you swap two assets from a liquidity pool, the less of one asset remains in the pool, the more of the other asset it costs to buy. Even if it gets down to very little, the price of it goes up exponentially, like you can see in this constant product function. Therefore, the pool basically never runs out of its assets. This is a good mechanism for most crypto assets with high volatility that behave more like traditional stocks, as they facilitate trading at all prices. However, it isn't ideal for pegged assets like stablecoins, which value should remain constant to the US dollar, for example. When you're exchanging 100 IUSD, which is worth $100, you want to get 100 USDC, also valued at $100, not less. Therefore, instead of the constant product function, a constant price function should be in place, making sure the amount of one asset is exchanged for the same amount of the other asset. But how do you make sure then that nobody buys out one asset from the pool? This is why there's a stable swap mechanism. Stable swap is the middle ground between constant product and constant price function. It uses a more complex algorithm called the stable swap invariant. It's a curve that is flatter around the optimal peg range. This means that traders can swap between two assets of the same value with minimal possible slippage and price impact. And liquidity providers can use stable swap pools with a reduced risk associated with impermanent loss, which could lead to deeper liquidity, higher volumes, and larger pool of fees. On WingRiders, you can see the stable swap pools marked like this in the pool section. When you'd like to exchange one asset for another one of the same value, such as two different USD stablecoins, go to Swap, select the assets, and you can see that you can actually choose the pool on which you can do so, either on the stable swap pool or on the constant product pool. In case of assets of the same value, you definitely want to swap on the stable swap pool to be exposed to minimal slippage. For your convenience, the stable swap is set by default. Now you can see that for 100 IUSD, you should get 99.94 JED. Let's see what would be the outcome if you selected the constant product pool for this stablecoins exchange. If you manually set the constant product pool, you see that for 100 IUSD, you'd receive only 61.3 JED because of the different formula. That's the magic of stable swap invariant formula that you can now benefit from on WingRiders when exchanging two assets of the same value.